calls for a probe of the government's widely criticized flood control programs. Pia Gutierrez has tonight's top story.
Residents of Barangay Sampaloc in the town of Talisay in Batangas observed the National Day of Mourning for the victims of severe tropical storm Christine, with a solemn mass held at the site of a massive landslide that killed about 20 people at the height of the storm last October. They were joined by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and other government officials who also lit candles for the victims. 69-year-old Alejandro Vargas says he still could not get over the trauma of losing his own wife and three grandchildren in the landslide which also completely destroyed their home.
Kami po natutulog nung panahon yun. Sa ganang akin po, lumabas po ako dahil may manok po ako ng mga sasabungin. Nag-away-away. Nung paglabas ko po, itinatali ko na si manok. So pagtingala ko po, ito na si malaking bato. Sa dami ng bagyong dumaan, di po kami naano. Ito lang po talaga si ko na namisala sa amin. Samantalang wala naman pong malakas na ulan nun eh.
On Monday, Alejandro was among the residents of Talisay who received government aid. This included construction materials to rebuild his destroyed house. But he admits he has no intention of ever returning to the site of his old home anymore because of what happened.
Yun na nga po ang aming iningin tulong sa kanila, yung mabigyan po kami ng magandang relocation. Talagang ang trauma kong natanggap hanggang kahit nakapikit po ang mata ko, nakikita ko pa rin po eh.
Aside from construction materials, the Office of the President turned over 10 million pesos each in financial aid to the towns of Laurel, Agoncillo, Talisay, Lemery, Cuenca, and Balete, which were severely hit by the storm. This is on top of the 10,000 cash assistance given to each selected farmer and fisherfolk affected by Christine.
Nais ko pong ipaabot ang aming taus-pusong pakikiramay sa bawat Pilipinong naapektuhan ng bagyong Christine. Itinalaga natin ang araw na ito bilang National Day of Mourning sa ilalim ng Proclamation No. 728. Batid namin na hindi madaling maibsan ang sakit na inyong pinagdadaanan. Ngunit, umaasa kami na sa suportang handog namin ngayon, kayo ay makapagsimula muli.
The President also vowed to expedite the repair and rehabilitation of damaged roads and bridges in Batangas, including the Bayuyungan Bridge in the town of Laurel. The mayor of the town, however, admits it will take a long time for them to recover from Christine, noting that almost 50% of their town were destroyed by the storm.
1 billion mahigit po ang kailangan para po maibalik namin sa normal, pati po yung mga hanap buhay ng aming mga kababayan na naapektuhan po ng bagyong Christine.
Matagal pa po ito?
Opo, medyo matagal-tagal pa po ito dahil ng ang problema po namin dito ay yung mga bahay na natabunan.
Flags in government offices in the provinces of Pampanga and Ilocos Norte were flown in half-mast as they joined the rest of the country in observing the National Day of Mourning. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. meanwhile vowed that his administration is working to strengthen the government's disaster response to prevent the further loss of lives amid the worsening effects of climate change. This, he says, includes improving the government's disaster communication strategies, better coordination with local government units, and the construction of disaster-resilient infrastructure. This as he admits that he was not satisfied with the government's response to Christine.
I'll tell you the truth. It's never enough. It's never enough. I wish we could do more. We're doing everything that we can. But, you know, when you lose a life, you lose a life. What can you do about that? It's terrible tragedy.
The president, meanwhile, defended his administration against criticism over the government's flood control projects, which critics point out were not effective in protecting communities from floods. He says he is open to any investigation on the projects, but notes that the flood control systems were simply overwhelmed by the large volume of water due to climate change.
Oh, sige.
Because of what's been happening.
Wala akong problem, but also they have to realize there are two sides to this. Sinasabi yung flood control, talagang na-overwhelm ang flood control natin. May flood control tayo, hindi kaya.
The Department of Agriculture reports 5.75 billion pesos in agricultural losses due to severe tropical storm Christine, of which almost 3 billion pesos of losses were recorded in the rice subsector. The Bicol region also sustained the most damage at almost 3 billion pesos.